Well, I'm back home from Vista, California. Yeah, I was gone for a solid week, and I did not get to play much with my Policar 312B2. That's what it is, a 312B2. And for Christmas, I got from my family this really cool two of these little lavalier microphones that are for iPhone. So, you know, I can always be with good sound. Well, at least, you know, I move the camera a long way away from me sometimes, and you know, I get all echoey and cheap sounding like, so hopefully this will improve that somewhat. I use my iPhone a lot because I do have a film studio and I have all the professional equipment, high-end 4K cameras and professional lavaliers and boom mics and all that stuff. But to set all that up to do a quick video is really kind of annoying. And then the videos sort of get very involved for editing and stuff. I just want to do stuff on the fly like everybody else. And it makes it kind of personal too. My dog's underneath. She has her own place underneath the slot car track down here that she likes to go into. Her own little place. I think the car is running around on top. Anyway, I've been babbling on long enough because I'm testing these microphones and I'm hoping they have good sound. What I'm going to show you is the Policar 312B2. It is B2, yes. Which I think is a Ferrari. You guys will correct me if I'm wrong, because I think every car that's red is a Ferrari or a Fiat. So let me show you what I found out. So I'm going to put a little bit of grease here that I got from Electric Dreams and see if I can get this all to be in camera. You don't need a lot. This tube's lasted me almost a year. So I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to... And this is the lube that I'm using. There are many on the market. And you can see I'm starting to get down there. But I still have enough. And I'll probably be going to Electric Dreams, I'm hoping, next weekend. With the Far Out Slot Card Club, because I'm a member of them. And I don't get to go and see them much or race with them because I'm a long way away from them. But they're going to have a setup day at... Electric Dreams, and I've always wanted to go there. I mean, I'm really close to it, about an hour and a half away. I mean, compared to some of you folks, that's close, so. And I may or may not take the Fiat. We shall see. So I'm going to just, there's a bearing on this one, and there's a bearing on that one, and I can't get to the shaft back here. Look at that. And that's interesting. They've got a noise suppressor on it. A little bit, tiny bit there. I wish I could get that back bearing, but this motor won't allow you to do it. So, this is a solid axle going through here. And those must be the adjustment points there. So I'm gonna put a little bit of oil on that as well. And that's it. I'm gonna try to adjust that axle next a little bit. Let's get it a little firmer to my track. So this is a nice little wrench that they give you. And I'm assuming that maybe it is for this. It is for that. So I don't know where the adjustments are for that or if they even exist. Doesn't look like they do. That looks like that's what that is, but it's not, because if I put this tool down there, which is pretty much the right size, I'm not hitting anything. I don't feel anything turning. No, I do not feel anything turning, and I can't even see. I can see that might be an oil point. I don't know, but there must be a way. See, I keep going on frame because I'm looking at the model and not looking at the frame. Well, I'm gonna look at this closer and see what we can see, find out. Nice the way they've done all this. Nice slot guide, nice braids, not overly thick. Tires are really sticky, which is always a good thing. So let's put it back together. Okay, so that was a really pleasant experience. And I say pleasant because if you've ever tried to take one of these apart, I mean, I really like them. You know, I don't knock Scalectric. You can see I removed the magnet, but there's, you have to be careful and take your time, especially with this Jackie Stewart model. The decals got a little messed up because they put the decals right over the seam. And the first time you open it up and figure out how to take this all apart to tune it up, you run into issues. So I really like the fact that Policar made this such a pleasant experience. And it was very much intuitive how to take it apart. The only other Policar I have is this one here. And it's Mark Tyler, my friend who I worked with in the motion picture industry, is also a slot car guy and a nice friend, and I've known him for years. He sent me this McLaren body, which I have yet to finish. It's got one of his drivers in it. I lost one of the inserts there, but it's you can see them there. And it's very nice running, and he suggested putting the Policar in there. So that was my first experience, and I noticed that they are very smooth and very quiet. I'm starting to get quite a collection of F1 cars. I love them, especially the Golden Era cars, which this 1970 or 71 certainly is part of. We started going to the Whale Tails at that point, but they weren't these gaudy, huge things sitting up here, and we still had a body design that had some artistic merit to it. When we went to this, it just wasn't as interesting to me. It's all function, and kind of like today's modern cars, they just don't have the same soul like any of these. although I did like the Audi, and we will talk about the Audi in another video, but I love this car. It's a somewhat newer car to me, and this test car is the SRC test car. That's also a sideways, incredibly good car, but I digress. You might notice this back here, and I know someone's going to write to me, what is that? Well, this is a Dan Gurney Eagle. This is the one that's got the very squared off looking windscreen, and I'm making a frame for it at long last, and this is the motor that I'm going to run in it. And I'm experimenting around with the frame. I got this new soldering station, which I really like. I have one at the studio, but the one at the studio is beat to death and really nasty looking after years of use. This one I got just for the slot cars. It's really nice. So I've got everything here. I've got my pins to keep this all squared up and nice when I'm soldering. And of course, I've got the ceramic pin board here to key everything too, and it's really fun, I think, to scratch build your own frames and make your own cars around them. I did it when I was, in my teens, 14, when my dad passed away in a car accident when I was 14, I kind of lost interest in slot cars. But we are back 100%, and I'm just so cool to be doing this. I've done it before. I've made a few frames, but none of them were not very nice until I got this and the pins, the proper pins and everything, and a good soldering station. So we're going to put this on the track and see how it runs. You saw how it ran in the Christmas video, Christmas Eve, Christmas Day. Here I am back 5 days later from Vista, California, and I'm just dying to play with this. So here we are on the track. I should stand, oh God, it just got quieter. This is a quiet car. I'm not going really fast, so you can see it. And again, the tires I haven't even done anything to yet. They stick that well. So well, I thought that they had a magnet in it, which it does not. Thank you, Policar, for not putting magnets in the car, because I like driving the car, not just holding down the trigger 100% and watching it go around at a really fast speed. And I actually prefer scale speeds, and I think a lot of our racing that we do, if there you don't have a magnet, forces you to kind of go at scale. Whoa, that's fast. Scale speeds. So clearly, compared to the first time I ran it, it's hard to keep up with. What did I do? Hit a dead spot? Huh. Interesting. Oh, brushes. I like to curl them up at the very ends like that. They seem to work better. Okay, there you go. Now, the tires are starting to pick up dirt on the track. And so, as a result, we are starting to slide around. So, but I'm going to true up the tires a little bit and get them sticky with the roller giddy. Mark sent me this, which I really like. I got to find some place to mount it, because you just put the car on that and you turn this. He 3D printed this, and it's really nice. But I need to put it somewhere like here. And I don't know if I can do that or not, or maybe over here. So I still have to get another Professor motor and add that to this. This is an old Ninco one. And after you've had one of these just feel, well, not very good. This power supply controls not the power to the track, but the power to the lighting on the track. And that's going to change, because I'm not using the ARC anymore to get lap times and stuff. I use the phone or the pad with the app on it, which works just as well as the ARC. And so I can bypass this and then run this into it, this little power supply down here, and control the voltage, which will be a nice thing. So that ends this test. I'm hoping the sound sounds okay, and that'll make for better videos in the future. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Slot Car Fun. It's great to be home. Looking forward to the New Year's and the New Year's weekend. I plan to do some shots and some laps several times on New Year's Eve. You guys have a great New Year's Eve and a great New Year's holiday. I love you a whole bunch, and we'll see you next week.